Alright, and so I'm continuing, yes. I forgot to include on all of my artwork memorabilia notifications that I'm also a surrealist. Oh my gosh, I just put abstract, and abstract is maybe not a clarification into surreal. So I have to add that addendum. Sorry, apologies, I forgot surreal. Yeah, surreality. Alright, so my main objective here, what was my main objective for pushing the button back again? It was, gosh dang, I'm kind of proud of it. I'm not proud of the website necessarily, but this little computer is so fun, actually, this new one I got. But, so there is my website, you see. And it's looking blue, though. My background image is blue, so something is different with the different what do we call them screens, because it's actually purple. It's actually a purple image. So here we have the favicon. If you didn't understand what one of those was, yeah. So I don't know. It's kind of a major have to, and nowadays we have to have our favicons. You don't have our favicons, we're just forget it. You don't have a favicon, you're nobody. So yeah, I don't know. What else was I up to? Gosh dang. I was talking about excessive. Now I'm having an excessive day for sure, because I put on I these on purpose. I put on the two necklaces. I'm having just a major excessive day. It doesn't necessarily mean eating and just that type of excess. I didn't mean fat foods. But yeah, it's just an excessive day, that's all. Where it seems like I'm not accomplishing anything fast enough, you know. So what does that mean? What does all this excessive represent? You know, what does all this excessive represent? This extraneous. Sometimes excessive itself feels as a clothing, doesn't it? It feels like a clothing to wear. Like I can fill my life with this. Here we go. We can. Well, no, I won't do a rosary style, but yeah, I can fill my life with this little excess, and then here's another excess, and then another. And we have all these excesses, and there's another excess. And an extra, and an extra, and an extra, you start having, what is the deal? A clothing. You start wearing a clothing. So when we get back into tribal man and tribal woman, here we are putting on our excesses. We're putting on our clothing right here at this moment. And so, yeah. So in a way, I'm covering myself. I'm covering myself as if, like I just need to be comfortable right now, like a blanket. It's not a bad thing. It's not a bad thing to overhave excesses sometimes. The bad thing is to not recognize it, I suppose, you know, because if you don't recognize it, then you end up living underneath the cloak of all of your excesses, and you don't even realize it. So yeah. So if you have all of these things that you feel comfortable in, and they're covering you, like a warm blanket, you know, you're warm fuzzy, you know, you're just like your hot chocolate or whatever you need sometimes, then there it is, you know, there's your excesses, and it feels good. But when you're covering yourself in the excesses, and I'm not necessarily meaning clothing per se, I mean in everything, excesses, your lavishries in needs. Your lavisheries in that they are your absolute needs and not your wants any longer. When that starts to be the mainstay, that you've modified away from the true reality that these are adornments, that these are adornments in your life. You know, you don't have to have the blinking, flickering lights that look like a candle outside in front of your house, no matter how beautiful. But that is an adornment. That is an excess. That is an exterior. That is not you. That is nothing to do with you. But when it becomes part of you, that it has to be your cloak, it has to be your clothing, it has to be something that you wear, you know, like your vehicle, make and model, like your girlfriend or your type, you know what I mean, or your boyfriend type, all of these things, you know, specified by this organism it's like an excess scale, your excess scale. And when the excesses have gone too far, that you don't identify them any longer as excesses, yeah, then there's some moments where you've lost yourself. Some moments where you've lost yourself. And you've definitely lost grounding, lost your grounded self. Because you are wrapped in you can say a wall. You're wrapped in a wall of all of these items. And it can be material. Yeah, we can state it as material items, sure. But it's also items on an emotional level, not just the material you know, things you purchase. It's definitely an emotional level. A collaboration of I have to have this sentiment stated. I have to have this sentiment stated in order to feel comfortable in a certain environment, you know. And you start adding on extra extraordinary, you know, this has to it has to have this extra cozy around it, doesn't it? It's extra cozy with everything. And so we can even go into the brutality of frankness. Now, the brutality of frankness does not have that, does it? Brutality of frankness the brutality of frankness can be an adornment also. I'll take that back. That can be an adornment of your excesses. Yeah. I guess that's what I'm really trying to get to. You know, we talk so much about materialism and all of the cloak and all of the wealth and all of the items, and here I am. I wanted to talk about the, just like that type of deal. Like the necessity, like I require this amount of my particular personality to be pushed to this particular distance. In and around other people. And when you have that happy place with yourself, that comfort, that is your adornment zone. And when you're in this adornment zone, it doesn't necessarily mean everybody else is loving it. It does not mean that. Yeah. And if you're in another place, when you're not frank, you're not frank at all. You're extremely, what do you call it? I don't know. Maybe they require a little bit more forthrightness. You're not giving forthrightness. And but that's your adornment zone, is to be in an area where you're definitely not, you're not forthright. You're meeking into things, and incredibly can be construed as shy. All right, so in that adornment of the self, that is another place that perhaps goes too far in people's minds. Yeah, so when we have our little comfortable adornments of ourselves, it doesn't mean they're great around other people. It doesn't mean they're loved by other people. Yeah. I guess fashion, we get into fashion, there is that simile, that moment that we can share. I guess people can share fashion as, hey, you know, at least that's one thing, you know. It's external though, isn't it? It's an external fashion event of, you know, your clothing or whatever. Rather than the adornment of your actual personality, and that comfortability that you're wearing. Yeah. So I guess in the shareness factor, we can all agree upon you know, what's in or what's out, you know, quite often. Just with the supply and demand of the materialistic items on the planet. Maybe that's why they've been so popular, you know, so popular extra. Because the other adornments are so difficult. The other adornments of the self are so difficult to have a good agreement with other people with, often.